Okay, she's a country music icon, and tonight, Loretta Lynn's grandson has been banned from a mid-state school. News 4's Carly Gordon joins us with the story you're not going to see anywhere else.
He's the one parent who isn't allowed at the school you see across the street, and the trouble all started at a junior high basketball game.
Unlike his world-famous grandma, Loretta Lynn, Ernest Lynn Jr. doesn't sing. Instead, he takes pictures. And that's what he was doing in his daughter's basketball game when the drama started.
He stood up in my face, came down at me like this, and said, "You're not going to take my picture." Like he was a WWE wrestler or something.
Lynn is talking about the principal of Waverly Junior High, Andrew Daniels, and Lynn admits he was being antagonistic.
So I stood up smiling, holding my $4,000 camera, and said, "You're in a public place, you represent my child's school, and I can take your picture if I want to."
Daniels ended up banning Lynn from his daughter's school. Lynn even got a call the next day from the sheriff asking him to stay away.
The sheriffs are acting as the principal's personal bouncers to settle a grudge.
Lynn missed his daughter's last five games, her award night, and tonight, Lynn is calling foul.
It's my right. I'm a photographer. I took his picture for 3.5 years.
We asked the sheriff if banning a parent was legal. After all, there aren't any criminal charges or order of protection. The incident didn't even happen at the school. It happened at an away game. The sheriff says there have been other people who have caused problems. We've asked them to stay away from the property in the past and haven't had resistance. Meanwhile, the director of schools isn't commenting, and so far, Principal Daniels hasn't called us back.
He needs to be reprimanded. There needs to be some kind of oversight.
Lynn filed a complaint with the school board. They decided they will allow him to attend his daughter's graduation. Still, Lynn says he's already contacted an attorney and is considering taking legal action. Carly Gordon, News 4.